Hi guys, Greg here from TATV. Whether you're a veteran reloader or just starting to think about getting into it, stuck cases are something that happen to the best of us from time to time. For example, when you're recording a new video and forget to confirm you're using the right size of shell holder in your press. Regardless of how it happened, removing a stuck case from a resizing die is actually a lot easier than you're probably thinking, so long as you take your time and have a couple of tools on hand. To remove this piece of 38 special brass from my Lee resizing die, I'm going to be using a reloading press, a Robertson screwdriver, a 3/4 inch wrench, a 1/2 inch wrench, and a rubber mallet. First, we're going to go ahead and screw the resizing die into a press. A single stage is by far the easiest to work with since there aren't any other dies in the way or powder measures or things like that. With that done, we're going to grab our 3/4 inch wrench and slide it over the die body. Then we're going to pick up our 1/2 inch wrench and start turning the depriming pin retention nut counterclockwise to loosen and remove it. With the depriming pin free, go ahead and insert the Robertson screwdriver into the top of the die body until you feel it come to rest on the bottom of the brass casing. Using the rubber mallet, gently strike the handle of the screwdriver. Remember to take it slow with this as it shouldn't take a lot of force to dislodge the brass. If you're using a turret or progressive press, you want to be extra careful not to use too much force or you could risk damaging the turret or the die holder. With the casing freed, we'll reinstall the die into our press and insert the depriming pin and retention nut, finger tightening both to avoid cross-threading. Now we'll use our 3/4 and 1/2 inch wrenches again to turn the retention nut clockwise and tighten it back into place. And we're done. Who knows, maybe going forwards I'll pay closer attention to what I'm doing next time.